to do. But Jesus said, we're talking about what you got right now, Martha. And I know you have all that, because Martha said, I got all that there. Jesus said, okay, hold on. So, here we go. Sometimes our faith is, we're going to find ourselves, I'm in my comfort zone with my faith, and it's running smooth. Don't bring nothing else to it. But the Lord wants us to be in tune. He sees that, you need some more expansion of your belief.
Therein is another test.
You need some more expansion of your belief. You got faith, but it needs to be expanded. See, he called folks old, little faith. You a little faith? Oh, you a little? What? I thought I was going to bring that. Yeah, little faith. All right, here we go back in our lesson again. Chapter 11, verse 5. Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. He was close to those. Okay, and then we're just going to jump. Verse 7. Then after that, he said he unto his disciples, let's go into Judea again. In other words, Jesus, you come back into this city, they wait to kill you. That's what we got in verse, up to verse 9. Because he had to run out of that town that they were in. Verse 10, he says, opportune. He's looking at opportunity. If a man walk in the night, he stumble, because there is no light in him. These things said he. After that, he said unto them, our friend Lazarus sleepeth. He's into the departing from the body. But I go that I might wake him out of sleep. See, he says, I'm going that I can do that. I can do that. I can wake him out of sleep. They don't know what he's saying. Jesus knows what he's saying. But Jesus also knows that when I get there, I got to have somebody with some faith that I can do that. Before we even get into our lesson, Jesus says, my friend, that's you and me, got some stuff going on, and I'm going to show up and see if they will believe that I can get in there and straighten out that stuff. As soon as I get to my friends. And that's what he, when he comes to us and says, we're going to ask him, hey man, get this taken care of. do something about this. And his question is going to be to us, is that, let's see where you are in faith on this. He says, I'm going that I can do it, that I might awake him out of sleep. Then said his disciples, Lord, if you sleep, he's all right. Then Jesus said, where is that? Verse 14. He said to them plainly, he's gone. And I am glad, what's said, verse 15?
And I am glad for your sakes that I was not there, to the intent that you might believe. Nevertheless, let us go.
I'm glad for your sakes that I was not there. Because here it is. When he's sick, they already know. We got you down, Jesus. Why? Right. We can see you.
Yeah,
we
can heal this sick.
We've been running with you. Me, Mary, Martha, Lazarus, and the lady that touched the garment. We was there when she did that. Oh, we didn't seem to do the stuff. And we know that if we get sick, all we had to do was what? Call on, we'll turn to you. You're going to get something done. He says, I see you got faith there. He says, I'm glad I was not there at that time to heal him of his sickness, because I would have done it. I would have been required, because you had faith for me to do that. But now he says, opportunity for expanded faith. And they ain't even in the same game that he's in. What? You talking about, man's already dead. Why are we going to go through all this travel? All right, here we go. Nevertheless, then he says, to the extent that you may, what? Believe. Get your faith up higher than what it is. Let us go. Nevertheless, let us go. All right, verse 16, they're thinking about physical stuff. Well, get your sword, guys, because it's the battle's on. We go back in that city. Bring the stuff.
Yeah, load up. Because we're going to be fighting because they already told us they're going to kill us if we come back. Here you go. Here we go. So this one of them says, I'm loading up because it's going to be a fight. And then when Jesus came, he found that he had lay in the what grave? Lesson picks up?
Verse
17. Okay. All right. Now, Bethany was nigh unto Jerusalem, about 15 furlongs. That's about 2 miles. And verse 19. And many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary to comfort them concerning their brother. This is tradition. We have the same thing in the black family, black church, black community. Folks, come in and cry with you. Cry. And you sit there and let them cry. Everybody's crying. And they might bring a cake with you when they come cry. Thank you, readers. Everybody's crying. It's called mourners. That's located in scripture. It's been going on for years. I think it's in
they have special mourners.
Yeah, they have to say, yeah.
Mark 5:38, so you see when people come in and mourn. They do the same thing. You don't believe me, die. You'll speak be loaded with cars, falling all over the place, bringing this thing. Everybody's crying. That's the comforters, the mourners. So, Mary, many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary to comfort them. One thing, when it says many of the Jews, is that this was a prominent family in some kind of way. Everybody knew them in some kind of way. I don't know what they did, but they were very popular. And then Martha, as soon as she heard that through all of this, that Jesus was coming, went and met him, but Mary kept doing her thing. Doing what? Sitting still in the house, allowing people to cry and moan. She was receiving the moment. She was still sitting there. But I'm pretty sure in her quietness, she's praying, meditating, and all that she knows. Even though this is tradition, she's got to receive the tradition in. And something happened to us. There's a lot of things that I don't like tradition-wise. But if something happens, I'll just let it go. Because I say that makes them feel good. Bringing me a kid. Because of my level of faith, it has no effect on comforting me whatsoever. But I says it makes them feel better that I allow them to come in with a slap of ribs.
And they think it makes you feel
better. And they think it makes me feel better.
And of course it does, that in doing that time, that somebody would think of
me. At least they thank you. Mm-hmm. And so she says, Mary's just sitting there taking it and absorbing it all in. Martha, she's had enough. First opportunity she can to get out of there, she's like me. Then she comes. She's gone. Thanks for dropping by. Because I heard that he was coming. Although it's after the fact, he's a friend of ours. And just like all the rest of y'all are friends, but I'm going to go meet him. There's a special connection between this family and Jesus. And she used that to get up and go. He's in the neighborhood. I'm going to go greet him before he gets here. Mary sat still in the house. So Martha is going to have a conversation with Jesus. Because Martha is that what? Personality type? Mm-hmm. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about it. I've seen you healed sick. You received the word in enough time that he was sick. And you're already 2 miles away. You could have got here while he was sick, and I was sick. He was sick. No big deal. What'd you do? Got a flight?
No, he was walking.
Why you didn't?
They were
walking.
And
they
have cars.
That's a perfect contrast, though, to two sisters' personalities.
Yeah.
The one is forceful and goes out, yeah. And the other one is still sitting there. Yeah.
Now, here's something, a clue, a nugget. If you're the type that's going to get up and do the cleaning and the work and the activity, well, guess what? Now. Activity is no good without work. Faith.
That's right.
Whoa. Got to get up and do this. Got to get that done. Whatever I do, moving and doing all this. Well, it's no good without faith. And so here she goes in her activity mode, getting active, I'm going to, and then Jesus is going to put it to her. Okay, let's see some faith. She heard, she's like, okay, I'm getting up, getting out of there. She moved her. So she gets with Jesus, she's going to have a conversation with him. If you showed up while he was sick, no problem. We had that covered. Faith-wise, we got that covered. He's just 2 miles away. So Jesus said, expand your faith. Because I want you to have more faith than what you got. Oh. All right. Someone read that. Verse 21.
Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if thou hadst been here, mm-hmm. my brother had not died.
Yes, she got that cup. You know what, Jesus? I do. When we put that demand on you, you had the answer. Because we seen you heal sick. We have no problem with you healing the sick.
You know, as I read it, it almost sounds like, you know, Jesus was a friend of this family.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, kind of, sort of, she was kind of reprimanding him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if you had been here, yeah. Brother Rod, you mm-hmm. shouldn't have been here.
Mm-hmm.
And if you had been here, this wouldn't have happened.
Yeah.
So, of sorts.
Yeah.
Because they felt close to him.
Yeah,
right.
To say
right.
And he didn't argue with her. She was like, I've been here. And that's what he was telling his disciples. I'm glad we wasn't there. Because I had to heal him. I would have healed him. And you'd see no more glory of God. Your faith would have been right there. And healed. That's as high as your faith would have went. Some of us is like that. We've seen God move. And that's where we left off in faith. And now he says, you have to expand. I want you to expand in your belief. What are the things I got to do? Some more hearing? And some more activity? So I got to do all this to get some more faith, because that's how it gets to me.
And you never come to the point where you have arrived.
You
have every time you have a test and you think, oh, I've overcome that one.
Yeah.
He just prepares you for the next one.
Because there is another one. There's
an
opportunity. You got to go to it. Let's see if you can go to another. I want you to go to another level. Because and David says, if I don't, this situation is going to hit me. So if I don't believe to see it in this land of the living, bad stuff. So I got to get there. And that's not why, but when bad stuff is happening, this is what the Lord is telling you. Come on and believe me. Come on and believe me. Yeah, you know I can, we agree that I could do all that, but come on and believe me. So she's coming to chat with him, he's coming to chat with her. Okay, here we go. Mm-hmm. All right, Lord, if thou had been here, let's see. Okay, verse 22. But I know that even now, this is Martha speaking, I know even now, whatsoever thou hast of God, God would what? Give it thee. I know that. But she has no, she don't know that about no raising people from the dead. She said, I still got faith in you that if you go talk to anybody, you find anybody else that needs healing, and you ask your father to heal them, you'll get it. I know that. So my sister Hill said, she's reprimanding him. You'll still be doing miracles. You're still going to be healing folks. You're still going to be doing all that. But if you, 2 days ago, you could have healed my brother. 4 days ago, you could have healed my brother. Well, who are you? Yeah, your friend, you could have healed him if you just healed. So I know even now you're gonna keep on healing. Keep on doing what you do. Yeah. Jesus said unto her, your brother will rise again. Your brother will rise again. So Martha is gonna say, she's gonna jump to, I know when we get to heaven. The pie in the sky, the golden streets, the pearls of gates, all the lights, walking around heaven all day. I already got that covered. You ain't telling me nothing new. And that's how some saints are. I'm on my deathbed, I'm on my sickbed, I'm on my wherever it is. And the next step is either glory, going into eternity. I believe it for right now down here. And a lot of folks would go and say, I go ahead and start believing. I know eternity's coming, I'm waiting to get there. I'll just take it like it is and go on and get there. I'm only 23 years old. 40, 60, 70, 80, 90. I'm ready to just go on and do it. Someone may say, tired. Tired? I'm tired. Don't want to believe no more. Don't want to expand no more. Don't want to get no more faith in that guy. Don't want to get no more disciplines. No more here. And here we go. He's giving her some knowledge. She said, I got it covered. When we die, going into the by and by, we got all that covered. Jesus says, are you missing something? Jesus said unto her, that brother shall live again. Martha said unto him, I know he shall arise again in the what? Resurrection. She's talking Old Testament stuff.
Yeah.
In the resurrection at the last day. A lot of folks going through eternity. Lose out on the glory of God, the goodness of God, because they don't have enough faith right now, and they're going into eternity waiting for the last day. Don't have to. This is what Jesus is telling you. You don't have to. You can expand your faith. Martha, are y'all with me here? So Martha, Jesus said unto her, verse 25, what?
I am the resurrection.
The resurrection. Now, so I am statement means just like I am has been heard before. Oh, Old Testament. Moses said, who are you? I am. Whatever you need me to be at any time, I am. Okay? I am. I am the resurrection. And life.
You can be a friend to Jesus and really
don't know the extent to how much of a Lord he is. I am the resurrection and the light. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. In other words, he is saying from your body and your spirit leaving your body, there's nothing that can keep me from putting your spirit back in your body. I am life. I am life. Now, if you don't know that I am Jesus, the one who's risen from the dead, you have life, but you don't have new life. And this is what many people don't understand. Even some believers, once they come to the Lord, do not fully realize that they have new life. New life. I'm honest, you look in the scriptures under new. If any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. New life. So now the old life, the old man, that life he had passed away. New life. What you got is resurrection life. What? Yeah, all of us right now. New life, resurrection life. Because you got the same life quality that Jesus currently has. Whoa. Now that'll blow your sockets if you're not anchored down.
Yeah.
You have the same life quality that Jesus currently has. The only reason why you leave this earth, your body lay down and die, is because it's just old and it can't take the body. It can't take no more of this stuff down. But the real you, the life, the real you, he don't change not one bit. He just goes into where he's supposed to go. But he can, as now living in your body, give you and make you whatever you can expand your faith for it to be. Wherever you take your faith, while you're down here, guess what has to follow? Your body. Your body. But some folks are lazy. They don't want to expand faith. One thing is weird, because folks look at you like you're crazy. I'm going to lose all my friends.
Yeah. And Martha has been going around saying, well, I know he can raise him from the dead.
Yeah.
You know, and she would have been looked at.
Yeah. People look at you like you're crazy. When you start talking about, I can do all things for Christ and strengthens me. And it's calling things that be not as though they're more than what. Believer would expand his faith to really believe. Call things that be not as though it exists, and it happens. Decree a thing, see it happen for you. Whoa. How do you get there? You have to expand your faith. And Jesus is always trying to get us to do what? Expand believing. Why are you down here? Expand believing. If he would have asked them, why'd you doubt? Why'd you doubt? Peter, you walking on water. Peter, why'd you step down? Why'd you stop believing? Okay, here we go. So I know that he should rise. Jesus said to him, I am the resurrection, the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall what? Never die. Believe thou this. See, this is what he's saying. Believe thou this. You got faith for healing. Let me see if you got faith for if a man died and I can raise him up again. You got that. Do you believe this? Whoa. Whoa. I saw you all those folks, but I never thought about getting to that level. So he says, believeth thou this. First Thessalonians 4th chapter, all of that talks to us about the afterlife. John 10 and 28. And then you got St. John 10 and 28. I would give unto them eternal life. They should never perish, neither should any man pluck them out of my hand. My Father which gave them me is greater than all, and no man should ever pluck them out of my Father's hand. That's what he said earlier in St. John the 10th chapter. So he gets her to believe in it, ask the question, believe in all this. Now the situation, the predicament you and I might be in, he says he wants to know right now today. Day in the situation, predicament arose. Believe in all this, that I can straighten this mess out for you. Believe it thou this. And she said unto him, what? Yea, Lord, I believe that thou art the Christ, the Messiah, the Son of God, which shall come into the world. And when she said that, then that pinpoint, okay, you with me, here we go. You with me, here we go. Yeah. verse 28, and when she had said so, she went her way and called Mary, her sister. How did she do it?
Secretly.
Because she got to do what? Build faith in Mary. You got to build faith in Mary. Here's a clue. You can't, some people, you ain't going to build faith. Some folks, you say, I'm believing for this, and you got to find you a believing partner. Say, can you believe with me? And they, can you don't, will you believe with me? Will you expand with me? Will you believe with me? And that's what she's doing with Mary. Mary, let me tell you something. This is what he said. The master has come and called it for thee. As soon as she heard that, she rose quickly. Jesus was not yet come into the town, but was in the place where Martha met him. The Jews then which were in the house, and what, crying and moaning, when they saw Mary, that she rose up hastily and went out, followed her, saying, she goeth into the grave to weep there. But Mary was come, where Jesus was, saw him, fell at his feet, saying unto him, Lord, if thou had been here, thy brother had still in healing faith. When Jesus therefore saw her weeping, the Jews also weeping, which came with her, he groaned in spirit and was troubled. See, man, this is the thing about, you know, don't put that up here, thing about funerals. That's the best place to go to find no faith.
Little faith.
That's the best place to go. Yeah, that's the best place to find a little faith. The scripture already said, why do you weep like other people? You weeping when you know what's really going on. But the crowd came around weeping, so we just joined in. Everybody was emotional, so we just joined in. Everybody was crying, falling all over the place, doing all this stuff. So we just joined in.
Okay, how then do you interpret verse
35? 35. Jesus wept, because he's a man with emotions. If I see Sister Deborah crying, guess what I'm going to do? If she yawn, guess what I'm going to do? Everybody cried.
But then he also weeped because of their unbelief.
Knowing where they were? Knowing where they were?
No, this is okay. This is Mary, the one that's got the priorities right. She's praying, she's attending to my words and all of that. And still, she don't even have enough faith to believe this.
The wrong crowd can bring your faith.
She's succumbing to the situation around her instead of.
And you know, sometimes, Sister Candy, that can happen. What you're saying, that the one that's supposed to have all the faith, mm-hmm. sometimes when those trials come, mm-hmm. then you see them. Weaken, mm-hmm. right? You see those people, then you think, oh, they have great faith. Uh-huh. You mean they are breaking down? And I want to go back to just the scripture you read earlier, Brother Williams, mm-hmm. Psalms 20.
7:13.
Uh-huh. That was David speaking, mm-hmm. and was talking about he would have fainted unless he had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. All the things that he had encountered and overcome when Saul was pursuing him and trying to kill him and all of this stuff. He was stating this out of experience.
Yeah.
And sometimes, then I think the next verse is key.
Okay.
Wait on the Lord and be of good courage,
and
he shall strengthen thine heart.
Yeah.
Wait, I say, on the Lord.
Yeah.
I think sometimes as believers, when we encounter those things, we don't wait on the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, our hearts are not strengthened where we don't faint.
Mm-hmm.
No,
mm-hmm.
we'll faint unless we wait on the Lord and allow him to strengthen our hearts.
Right, move too quick. And,
exactly.
Here he's in this environment with weepers. And they come to cry over the negative fact that Lazarus is dead. They're crying. They followed Mary out here. Crying and weeping and moaning and doing your thing. And so we all have emotions, and you can bring somebody's emotions into where you are. If you crying, if you happy, everybody joining. So Jesus wept. She sure he had knowledge that their knowledge was very low, therefore their faith was very low. And when I go to funerals, and you can tell what that faith is. Oh, man. Well, can't build no faith in this arena. Say what you want to say. Anybody can do nothing in here. And he could do no mighty work because of their what? Unbelief. He wept because he's human too. You know, he's human. So he wept. Now why did he weep? Well, the Jews said how he loved him. How he loved that family. So he don't want to see us hurting and crying and all that. He doesn't want to. And then we know what happened after that. He raised the guy up. But you have to, when you're expanding faith, emotions got to be in check. Your mind has got to be renewed and expanded, and you got to hear, and you got to put yourself in position to hear so that you can expand.
And you have to have that knowledge.
Yeah, you got to gather knowledge. Right. So that you can expand.
And then wait.
You know, and the situation I think with David, too, to understand that at the time he wrote that, he was running for his life.
Running for his life.
And he had a whole bunch of folks with him, or about 400 of them that was really with him. I've got these folks with him, but they ain't in no better situation than I'm in. They can't help me.
David had a bunch of losers running with him at that time. So he had to believe that.